السلام علیکم ورحمۃ اللہ وبرکاتہ۔ شبہات کا ازالہ پیج کو سبسکرائب کریں اور بیل آئیکن دبائیں سب سے پہلے ویڈیو دیکھنے کے لیے۔
بسم اللہ الرحمن الرحیم۔ رائیون مرکز۔ The Tablighi effort was revived by Hazrat Ji Maulana Ilyas Sahab Rahmatullah Alayh, and whoever joined him began to be called Tablighis. So some etiquettes and principles were built. Maulana Ilyas Sahab Rahmatullah Alayh made Banglawali Masjid as the Markaz, and people considered it and called it Markaz. There people would learn the effort from him, continued the effort for their self-rectification, and the work continued to spread. Soon the India-Pakistan partition was made, and Markaz Raivand was made the main Markaz of Pakistan. Initially, the people of Raivand Markaz were completely following Markaz Nizamuddin. The direction of Tablighi politics and its beginning in Raivand Markaz. Just like the active people behind every new group and party try to stamp their authority and direction to prove their fame and capabilities by introducing new ideas and visions, the political people behind Raivand Markaz did the same. Changes made from the Tabligh of Maulana Ilyas Sahab Rahmatullah Alayh. Change number 1. Raivand change to Tashkil and send public Jamaat for 1 year. Nizamuddin methodology, only 4-month Jamaats were Tashkil for the public. Change number 2. Raivand change to go abroad in Jamaat, a minimum age restriction of 40 years old was fixed. Younger people couldn't go abroad. Illa Masha Allah. Nizamuddin methodology, no such restrictions. Anyone with understanding of the effort who could work with the Jamaat could go. Change number 3. Raivand change. 353 Tartib in old workers' door. Nizamuddin methodology, there was no such lucky number method here. Change number 4. Raivand change. 1.5 year Tartib. Nizamuddin methodology, 4 months for public and 1 year for ulama. Change number 5. Raivand change. Muzakara Jamaat. Nizamuddin methodology, listen to Hidayat, that's Rawangi talk, before you leave and give Karguzari, that's returning reflection upon return. Change number 5. Raivand change. Supreme Shura. First the Raivand Shura decide something, then this was presented to the Supreme Shura, who would analyze, tear it apart, keeping some things which would come into practice. The Supreme Shura is openly in opposition to the method of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and is perfectly consistent with the Supreme Communist Party Council. We have only learnt one thing with regards of this in Tabligh. There is no Mashwara before Mashwara and no Mashwara after Mashwara. Nizamuddin methodology, no such Supreme Shura. Change number 7. Raivand change. Jour of old working women with their husbands for 15 days. Nizamuddin methodology. No such jour. Just for a couple of hours at a Purana Sati hidden house for karguzari and short talks. Nothing more. Change number 8. Raivand change. Old worker practices with new workers and explains the effort to them. Nizamuddin methodology, no such tutoring method. Similarly, plenty of other methods were implemented which were never heard of in Nizamuddin, nor were they ever seen there. This means that from its early days, the political people behind Raivand Markaz would implement their political agendas without either consulting or even asking Markaz Nizamuddin. With such a sadness, would Hazrat Ji Maulana Inamul Hasan Sahib Rahmatullah Alayh say, the people of Raivand Markaz have never counted us as an Amir. We are the one who keep them as our companion. If we ponder over each word of the sentence that the worldwide Tablighi Amir Sahab is complaining with such heartfelt sadness in her. The politics of Raivand Markaz, the political achievements of the Alami Shura from Pakistan. First, formed the Alami Shura which Maulana Saad Sahab didn't accept. Second, pressurized Darul Ifta of Darul Ulum Deoband to issue fatwas against Maulana Saad Sahab. Third, brought the fatwa to the attention of the public, causing worldwide disruption. Fourth, the rebellious group blackmailed Maulana Saad Sahab by saying, accept the Shura or else face the fatwas of Deoband. If you accept the Shura, the fatwas will automatically become cancelled. They dictated to Darul Ulum Deoband to wait so the Alami Shura can be accepted. But this didn't happen. Never until Qiyamah, insha'Allah. the plan of Alami Shura, the rebellious group which has deserted Nizamuddin Markaz, has planned to denounce listening and obeying one Amir, instead accepted the Alami Shura, that's World Council, no proper Amir but a decision maker, who is rotated in responsibility week by week, month by month and year by year. This ensures the method of Nubuwwah is destroyed and the method of communism is established. The evil intentions of this communist shura to kill off the Markaz Nizamuddin and its status, to dissolve the Amir and Imarat, to devolve the effort of Da'wah temporarily to the Alami Shura, to then instigate the Alami Shura to fight amongst itself, to take the effort of Da'wah and movement of Anbiya by the throat and finish it off forever. This is such a dangerous conspiracy that the fitna of the Tatars and Cengiz fitna are overshadowed. May Allah defeat the Alami Shura and its promoters. Ameen. Deoband and Jamiatul Ulama. In 1980, in the Darul Uloom Deoband 100-year Jalsa gathering, when Indira Gandhi appeared uninvited, her heart began to burn with jealousy at the 15,000-strong mega gathering. Through her hints, the puppet of the Congress of that day, Maulana Asad Madni, began his propaganda against the 60 years of Khidmat experienced principal Qari Tayyab Sahib Rahmatullah Alayh. The propaganda was so influential that even sincere entities like Maulana Abul Hasan Nadvi and Maulana Manzoor Nomani also became influenced. Then on the dark night when Qari Tayyab Sahib Rahmatullah Alayh was finally demised on 23rd March 1982 and a Congress approved interim executive board was initiated. Then there Maulana Abul Hasan Ali Nadvi and Maulana Manzoor Nomani's eyes opened. They repented deeply with humility and shame and as a result never returned to Darul Uloom Deoband again during their lives. Oh, claimers of the Alami Shura, a similar attack was already made upon Jamiat Ulama before. Then at his, Maulana Asad Madni's death in 2006, just like how his brother Maulvi Arshad Madni and his own eldest son played his war game to claim the leadership of this Jamaat, as if it were his very own inheritance, was sufficient to open even the eyes of those who were drawn into them head to toe. Plots of the Alami Shura against Maulana Saad Sahab, acting upon the example, the bright sparks of this group plotted three ways against Maulana Saad Sahab. Plot 1, to say that Maulana Saad Sahab has moved away from the style of Dawah of the Tablighi elders. However, this Alami Shura fitna have failed to substantiate this claim with any evidence. Plot 2, to say that Maulana Saad Sahab is deviated in his theories and specifications of this work, his explanations, and has separated himself from our pious predecessors. They even managed to collude with Darul Uloom Deoband for this, used and abused them, and managed to get fatwas published against him. However, the ulama of Tabligh and other ulama of truth clarified ilm-related accusations held against Maulana Saad Sahab with open clarity and proved each of these points in light of Quran and Hadith, all in his favor, to the extent that even the Muftis of Darul Uloom Deoband have not managed to reject these answers. We have also requested them many times that if our answers are correct, then support us. If they are wrong, then reject us. Instead, they have chosen to remain silent on this matter. Plot 3. The final plot, when nothing happened in their favor, was that they brought into practice by means of this shura whatever they choose. And this Alami Shura, based on a communist ideology, has been rejected by ulama and muftis of Haqq, who proved in their speeches and in written how it has been rejected. Now this shura has fallen apart and blown away like dust. Unfortunately, with it, it sunk the respect, dignity and admiration of Darul Uloom Deoband. At the beginning, Maulvi Arshad Madni supported them a lot and badly criticized Maulana Saad Sahab. He is a child, his knowledge is raw and his upbringing etc. etc. Now he has landed upon his own head a significant issue that 95% of the Tablighi public don't hold Darul Uloom Deoband in the same esteem compared to before. And the main reason of Maulana Arshad Madni's comments and the non-sunnah fatwa of Mufti Abul Qasim. Remember, Lenin and Stalin had power and subsequently killed 5 million Muslims. If this Alami Shura had power, they would not leave their opponents either. However, this evil Dajjali fitna has broken the Ummah into small fractions. They attacked Maulana Saad Sahab with their lives and made a mockery of his respect and dignity. After the funeral of Maulana Zubair Sahab Rahmatullah Alayh, these fitna people said to Maulana Saad Sahab, "Wrap up your bedding and stuff. We are bringing a truck and you will have to vacate Nizamuddin immediately." When things had reached such a dire state, then the people of Delhi and Mewat made a firm decision of getting rid of this evil mafia. Soon this mafia scattered and deserted Nizamuddin, thinking there is some good in doing that, and have now formed their